Hello everybody, this is Punk Demon Neo and welcome back to the Sonic Adventure DX playthrough. Last time we finished the story of E-102 Gamma in Adventure Mode, which means all six of the main playable characters, their stories are complete. However, we are not done with this game just yet. There is still one extra part of Adventure Mode to play through, and it is Super Sonic. Super Sonic's story only becomes available upon completing all six main character stories, and this is the big one, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be the finale for the Sonic Adventure DX playthrough, at least for Adventure Mode, because it's time to play the final story with Super Sonic. Here we go!
I hate that Sonic. He always seems to get in my way. I bet he can't foil my master plan. Chaos!
The Master Emerald is where it belongs. But Angel Island is still falling. This doesn't make any sense. Maybe those Chaos Emeralds that I brought back with me have something to do with what's happening. I'll take them to Sonic for his advice. Eggman!
This is terrible! Chaos is...
Is what?
Yes, Eggman learned his lesson. Yep. And maybe I'll take another vacation somewhere.
Sonic!
Hey there, Tails! Did you find the tornado too?
Never mind that. Get up and follow me. Angel Island is falling again.
Hey, no way! Who blew it this time?
Oh, I don't know, but we better hurry!
And after that string of cutscenes, we're back in control of Sonic for the final story of the game. And most of the playable action at first is going to be concentrated in the Mystic Ruins area. And one interesting thing is that I actually tried this in a previous practice run through the final story. You can actually access some of Sonic's actual levels here in the final story. I guess because, even though it's supposed to be Super Sonic, you're technically playing as Sonic himself, so yes, you can actually visit some of Sonic's levels in Super Sonic's story, but obviously we're not going to do that. We need to see what's going on here. I think Chaos has had enough of being Dr. Eggman's little minion, and he might be going into business for himself. So it looks like we're about to have a very big mess that we're going to need to clean up.
Sonic, sorry.
Knuckles and Eggman, What happened here?
He stole my Chaos Emeralds. And Chaos is still alive.
What?
Ah! He's not gonna get away with this!
Hey, Eggman! Wait up! Sonic, Chaos is a fearsome beast. If he gets that last Chaos Emerald, we're done for.
No need to explain. We'll get on it. Tails?
Right!
What?
Oh, jeez! This place, it looks familiar. It's not a dream after all.
All right, we're back in the past once again, ladies and gentlemen, and this is very similar to the vision Sonic had at the end of his story with the Master Emerald Shrine engulfed in flames. And this last vision, more or less, is where everything finally starts to come together. So, let's move on and see what's going on.
It's a monster! No!
Forgive the Captain Obvious commentary here, but I have a feeling this can only end badly. And I'm not sure what we can really do about it.
Hey, are you alright?
I think so. Oh my gosh!
Wait up!
The seven emeralds are the servers. Chaos is power enriched by the heart. The controller serves to unify the chaos. The seven emeralds can change our thoughts into power. If this emerald controls that power, please, you must stop him. Wake up!
I was on a snooze cruise, I guess.
Good thing you're okay. You just sort of conked out there. Knuckles left already. Come! We gotta go after the last emerald!
Lead the way!
It should still be on board the Tornado too!
Well, that, last vision, like I said, it did tie up some loose ends. Like, we know what happened to the ancient Echidna civilization now. They angered Chaos, and he decided to put them in their place, but it looks like T'Kal, apparently using the Master Emerald, managed to calm Chaos before he did any worse than he did. Something tells me that may come into play this time, unless we can get this last Chaos Emerald. There's still a chance, ladies and gentlemen, we could prevent total catastrophe, but something tells me it's not going to be that easy.
Look! It's the Tornado! Tornado too!
Yeah, so let's get the Chaos Emerald and leave. What? No! He's got the last emerald!
Now what do we do?
If I wasn't just dreaming, that monster is a real menace. Eggman! Looks like he's after Chaos too.
If Egg Carrier 2 was made because something like this could happen, you have defied your master, stupid beast. Now it must be destroyed at all costs.
Enough. Who do you think you are, anyway? Oh, it's you! The one who sealed Chaos in the Master Emerald, Tikal.
My heart has always been in the Master Emerald, along with Chaos's. Now he's filled with anger and sadness. And if it goes on, he'll eventually destroy the world like he did before. Look! He's absorbed the Emerald's power! He must be sealed in the Master Emerald now!
How can that help? It won't change how he feels inside, will it? His heart will still remain in turmoil, and his anger just won't vanish. He'll just be trapped forever!
What choice do we have?
Amy!
Here, take this!
Hey guys, what's up?
Chaos only used the negative power of the emeralds. Sonic, you should be able to harness their real power!
As much as I hate to admit it, I think Tails is right about this. Sonic! Yeah, Sonic!
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 Negative forces aren't the only way to empower the Chaos Emerald. Our positive feelings toward each other can make them work. Our hearts together form awesome power.
It's on, ladies and gentlemen, time for the final boss of the game, Perfect Chaos. Chaos has certainly been perfected, and he's definitely laid the perfect smackdown on the city of Station Square, but we now have our equalizer. It's time to play as Super Sonic. This boss fight is actually very simple. As Super Sonic, you simply need to build up enough speed until you reach Perfect Chaos. If you reach Perfect Chaos with enough speed, you will travel up his body and inflict damage on his brain, which will take away his health. Do this 3 times and we move on to the second phase. He's already down to 1 hit left, and we've got an awesome music track in the background. We've actually got the main theme song of the game in the background, called Open Your Heart by Crush 40, I believe, who have done plenty of songs for the Sonic series, and boom! But we're not done yet. The music changes, which means we are at the second and last phase of the battle. And here we go. This one's going to be a little bit more difficult because of Chaos's attacks. Chaos's attacks are going to come much more frequently, and he'll try to push us back so we can't damage him. I don't think I actually built up enough speed. Oh, I did! Okay. So this is actually the first playable appearance of Super Sonic in a main series Sonic game in 3D. There was a 3D rendition of Super Sonic in Sonic R for the Sega Saturn, but that is a spin-off, so I don't technically count it. Let's go ahead and deal the next hit, avoid the last energy blast, and didn't think I actually had enough speed. Alright, 1 hit left. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. We are 1 attack away from finishing off this playthrough. As Super Sonic, you don't have to worry about taking damage, but you need to be careful of your ring counter. You run out of rings, you lose the battle, but that isn't gonna happen! Chaos is finished.
Hey, I'll play with you some other time.
That's it, final boss defeated, playthrough done.
Chaos has changed again, this time for the better.
Yeah! Super Sonic must have neutralized it, so it's nice again.
These are the Chao you were protecting. They stayed alive for generations and now live peacefully with humans. The fighting's over, harmony's restored, and life goes on. you so much.
All's well that ends well, right? Sonic?
And just like that, Sonic's off on his next adventure. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the conclusion of the Sonic Adventure DX Adventure Mode. And, oh man, first thing I gotta talk about is that final line from Tails, "All's well that ends well." It's a much derided line because he says that, yet he's standing in a city that Chaos destroyed with possibly maybe thousands of people dead. And he goes, "All's well that ends well," right? Oh my goodness. Alright, but enough about that little bit. I just had to get that in there. But yeah, that was the final boss of the game. Not too much to Super Sonic Story. Basically, Super Sonic Story is essentially the culmination of everything else that's happened. All the characters come together. Sonic is able to transform into Super Sonic and, you know, in glorious 3D, at least for the time, we get to finally see Super Sonic in 3D in a main series Sonic game. And, yeah, the boss battle against Perfect Chaos isn't really that difficult. I mean, like I said, all you have to do is build up enough speed, avoid Chaos's attacks because his attacks will slow you down. You have to build up enough speed to be able to travel all the way up his body. If you don't have enough speed, you'll just fall out and Chaos will reform somewhere else and you have to do the whole cycle again. That battle can be frustrating though if you're not good at avoiding the attacks, especially in the second phase. In the second phase, when he gets more numerous and more aggressive, you can definitely find yourself not having enough speed to hit him. And as I said before we actually won the battle, since you're Super Sonic, you're constantly losing rings. You have to collect rings to maintain your super form, and if you don't do that, Sonic will lose a life and you have to restart the battle. But hey, it is actually a pretty good finale to the game. I mean, of course, you know, in the first phase of the battle, you get to hear the main song of the game, which is actually playing right now over these credits. And I guess I ought to go ahead and just cut to the chase here and start composing my final thoughts here for the whole playthrough. I know I say this with every playthrough I do, but I did enjoy this game and putting together this playthrough for the channel. Sonic Adventure, the original Dreamcast Sonic Adventure, was actually the first Sonic game I ever played. I grew up in the era of the classic 2D Sonics, but I never owned a Genesis until I was like 11, 12 years old. So my first exposure to Sonic was through the 3D game, starting with Sonic Adventure, and I loved this game. For a long time, Sonic Adventure was one of my favorites. And I have to say, I don't want to say it's a bad game. I still think there's good stuff in this game. It has good things to offer, but it hasn't aged well. It's definitely been surpassed. You know, I think Adventure 2, Sonic Generations, Sonic Colors have surpassed it. And let's be honest, Sonic has had a rough going in the 21st century. But I still love the Sonic franchise, and all the problems I have with this game, this game just comes off as it just needed some polish, you know? It just needed a little bit more polish, which unfortunately didn't really get added in with the DX re-releases. But overall, I don't want to say this game is bad. It's not a bad game. It's an enjoyable game. It's not an all-time classic, but I enjoyed this playthrough. I enjoyed going through the different characters and stuff. And I definitely am glad that I went with this game for a playthrough. There it is, ladies and gentlemen, Supersonic 100%, so that is every character in Adventure Mode complete. The entire story has now been wrapped up, and there's really not much left for me to cover for at least the Adventure Mode of this game. And really, again, that was really all I really intended to cover for this playthrough. It was just to go through the Adventure Mode and go through the story with all the characters. And as I was saying during the credits, you know, even the characters I don't really like Amy and even Big the Cat, you know, I found myself enjoying every character in one form or another. Again, even Big the Cat, I started actually enjoying a little bit when I was recording him for the playthrough. And like I said, this game, I'll admit, it has not aged well over the years, but again, I hesitate to call it an out-and-out bad game. It's a decent game at worst for me. It's definitely got some problems. It's got some glitches and bugs, and there is definitely a lack of polish with it. But still, you know, there's still that big nostalgia factor I have with this game that I guess that's what keeps me from saying this game is bad, you know? Like I said, this was my first exposure to Sonic, and even, you know, and when I was young, it was indeed one of my favorite games. And it's still a game that, like I said, I'm still glad that I decided to cover this for my channel, because this is definitely a game that was a big part of my formative years, like my early teenage years when I managed to get my hands on a Dreamcast back in the day. So having said all that, I think it's time to wrap things up here. So that is it. That is the conclusion of the Sonic Adventure DX playthrough, at least for the Adventure Mode. If you folks enjoyed this playthrough, be sure to give me your thoughts on the playthrough as a whole. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. And I hope to see all of you in the next video.